Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in this video we will study a new chapter called as microcontroller. Now before starting a microcontroller, we need to understand the difference between microcontroller and microprocessor. Now what is microprocessor? That we already know. The chip which is installed in our computer, we called it as what? Microprocessor. Now if you see the difference between the microprocessor and microcontroller, you can say microcontroller can be used for the online applications, whereas microprocessor can be used for the offline applications. So let us see what is microcontroller in detail. Microcontroller, let us see a definition of microcontroller. A microcontroller is a complete microprocessor system consisting of microprocessor, limited amount of ROM, EPROM, RAM, input-output port built on single integrated circuit. So you can say a microcontroller has a limited amount of memory than whom? Microprocessor. And in the starting of the video, we have already discussed the basic difference between microcontroller and microprocessor is that microcontroller can be used for the online applications, whereas microprocessor can be used for the offline application. So our home computer is, you can say, it is a microprocessor, whereas your ATM machine, okay, which works only online, you can call it as what? Microcontroller. So what my definition of microcontroller says, a microcontroller is a complete microprocessor system, but it has the limited amount of memory into it. It has the limited amount of RAM, it has the limited amount of ROM, EPROM, and input-output ports, and all they are integrated on the single IC. It is in fact a microcontroller, but it is called so because it is used to perform a control function. As we discussed, it is used to perform what? Control function. So that's why it is called as microcontroller. It is more complex than microprocessor because it consists of many input and output component. Example of the microcontrollers are Intel 8048 and Intel 8051. In this topic, we are going to discuss more about Intel 8051 microcontroller. Next is applications of microcontroller, or you can say advantages of microcontroller over microprocessor. So number one advantage is that it is a low cost. It is low cost than what? Microprocessor. So the cost of microcontroller is less than microprocessor. Number two, we have already studied microcontroller has more input-output component. So that's why we called it as what? It is more complex. Why it is complex? Because it has more input-output component. Number three, it can be used in many low-cost products such as electronic toys, or it can be used in the microwave ovens, or it can be used in the machines, it can be used in the chemical instrumentation, it can be used in the medical instrumentation, and so on. It can be used in the wide variety of intelligent products such as your personal computers, keyboard. So these are some of the applications of microcontroller over microprocessor. The number one we saw, it is low cost, it is comparatively cheap than whom? Microprocessor. Then number two, it is complex because it has many input-output component. Then we saw it can be used in wide variety of the low-cost products such as what? Electronic toys, then machines, then medical instrumentation, chemical instrumentation, etc. And it can be used in the wide variety of intelligent products such as what? Personal computer keyboards. Now next we will see what are the features of microcontroller. Now we will have look onto some features of 8051 microcontroller. Now this question is very important as per your exam, because this question may come for 3 marks or it may come for 4 marks. So obviously if it comes for 3 marks, you have to write any 6 features, and if it comes for 4 marks, then you have to explain at least 8 features. So let us have a look onto a feature. Number one, it has 8-bit ALU. We already know what is ALU, arithmetic and logical unit. So 8051 microcontroller has 8-bit ALU. Number two, it has 4 kilobyte of ROM. Number three, it has 128 bytes of RAM. So the ROM is of 4 kilobyte and the RAM is of 128 bytes. So you can compare, you can see how limited memory it has as compared to whom? Microprocessor. Next, it has 16-bit dual time event counter. It can address up to 64 KB of program memory, and it can address up to 64 KB of data memory. Then it has powerful instruction set consisting of 111 instruction. What is instruction set? That also we have studied in the microprocessor. So same as a microprocessor, microcontroller 8051 microcontroller has some instruction set, and there are around 111 instructions into it, and it has two external interrupt. So these are the eight features of microcontroller. We'll have a recap of these eight features again. Number one, it has 8 bit of ALU. The number two, it has 4 kilobyte of ROM and 128 byte of RAM. Then it has 16 bit dual time event counter. It can address up to 64 KB of data memory as well as program memory. Then it has the powerful instruction set, consists of 111 instruction, and it has two external interrupt. So these are 8 important features of microcontroller. Thanks for watching this video. In the next video, we will study a memory map of 8051 microcontroller. To watch the latest video, please subscribe the channel eKida.